The gifts are irrevocable. I said it, irrevocable. But you can lose your salvation. No, the gifts are irrevocable. Your salvation is a gift. It's irrevocable. Your eternal life is a gift. It's irrevocable. The Holy Spirit is a gift. He's irrevocable. The power of the Holy Spirit is a gift. It's irrevocable. The gifts and the fruit are all irrevocable. His call is irrevocable. Well, God might reject you. His call is irrevocable. God does not change his mind. He is not a man that he should lie. He is not a man that he should change his mind. He is a good God. He is not like us. He is not evil. He is a good gift giver. And when he gives gifts, he does not ask for them back, nor does he take them back. For the gifts and the call are irrevocable. Next scripture, 1 Corinthians 4:7 says, what do you have that you did not receive? And if you did receive it, why do you boast as though you did not? See, there's a part of us, myself included, all of us, that wants to earn the favor and the acceptance of God. We want to do good in order to earn God's love and favor. All of us were practically born in a competitive environment, in a performance-oriented environment where love came as a result of us being good, not because God was good and he loved us as sons because of our relationship and our right standing with him as sons, but it was always conditional based on our behavior or our performance. But God is not like that. And the kingdom of God and the system of God and the principles of God and the plans of God are that you receive all of his gifts by grace through faith, lest you boast about all that you've done for him and tell everybody about your goodness and not his goodness and your greatness and not his greatness and your obedience, but not his obedience. And let's just keep going. Watch this. John 3:27 says, a man can only receive what is given him from heaven. Only. A man can only receive. Only. That's it. He can receive nothing more than what is given from heaven. No man can do anything unless he's filled with the Spirit of God, operates and allows the Spirit of God to operate through him, and has the power of the Holy Spirit. No disciple ever did anything good unless it says first he was filled with the Holy Spirit, who is given by grace and is a gift from God that comes from heaven. God is a gift giver, and the only thing that you can receive from God, it has to be given and it has to be received through believing, not achieving. This is the system, and these are the principles of God, and these are the secrets to the kingdom of heaven, so that no one may boast before him and tell everybody about how good he is. Let's go to the next slide.
Thank you for watching I Believe X. You've now been marked in him.